Yes, well, this is a very interesting issue. I guess when the pandemic started, many people expected that the house prices would remain steady or even fall because of the economic downturn, but this is not what happened. For instance, in the Nordic countries, although there are big regional differences, house prices have been increasing across the board. Now, one explanation put forward for this is that given that households have spent more time in their homes, they have wanted to upgrade their housing, maybe because of more remote work and maybe because of lockdowns and restrictions in service consumption. Now, this may be one explanation, but I think that there are also alternative ones. One big issue is related to very low real interest rates. Now, low interest rates affect the cost of housing, especially for owner housing, and this may be one explanation behind what we are observing. Now, given the increased inflation anticipation, the real interest rates have actually been coming down now that the economies are recovering from the effect of the pandemic. This means that especially for households who are not severely borrowing constrained, the cost of financing housing has become even more cheap than it used to be. And now in big cities where housing supply is very constrained, the effect has been higher housing prices. So I actually think that given the recent development, these housing pricing reactions are more or less understandable. Now, of course, there are risks. More generally, if one thinks about the housing market, very high house prices are sort of a natural reaction of very low real interest rates. And high house prices relative to the income of households make the housing market vulnerable in the sense that even small reductions in house prices could lead to big reductions in aggregate consumption. Now, going forward, it is of course possible that given the inflationary pressure that we currently see, the central banks will be forced to increase the nominal interest rates. This could mean that real interest rates actually increase and become higher than the households have used to expect during the last decade or so. This could mean that especially highly leveraged households and households that have a lot of debt relative to their income might face difficulties in serving their debt. And these are the risks that we are currently facing. Of course, there are differences between countries, there are institutional differences, and the risks are not similar everywhere. But the important thing to acknowledge is that housing wealth and housing as an asset is different from the point of view of the macroeconomy than financial wealth, because housing wealth is much more evenly distributed than financial wealth, and therefore it is likely to have bigger aggregate impacts also.